Well, the reason why we're making our mural is for African American History Month, which is a month, but we really should celebrate all cultures all the time. And so one of the people that we'd like to take a closer look at is Harriet Tubman. And you're going to understand why in a few minutes, and then you're going to do another activity together about the Tuskegee Airmen, which I pulled out already, so that you guys can also learn about that. This group is totally capable of reading this aloud for you. Perfect.
So we're going to talk about Harriet Tubman, who was a very prominent African-American woman, and we're going to recognize her because we are paying tribute to African-American History Month, okay? So we're going to find out why she is so important. Who was Harriet Tubman, and why is she important? When we are reading the story, we're going to make sure that we are paying attention to these words here that we come across when we are reading. So the words are brave.
Oh, will they be bolded? That's a good question. In here, I don't recall them being bolded, but they go back to that question and they help you focus on what the topic of the story is. So they're not vocabulary words. They're not words that you would look up in a glossary, so to speak, but they're focus words. They're words that you need to know. Good question.
Yes, very good question, which is why they're bringing it to our attention before we read the story. So that way we know, keep our eyes open for these words when we're reading
the
story. Right. Well, we'll refer back to them again after the end, but we want to see and pay attention to where they are in the story. So those words are brave, careful, caught, danger, escape, and slavery. Rocco?
By looking at those words, I made a prediction and I think I know what's going to happen in the story.
Did you? Would you like to share with us some
about
more?
Maybe she's a slave and she escapes, and maybe when she was a slave, she would was careful and brave, and maybe she was caught to be a slave, and it would be about danger.
Well, we can definitely find that part
or
out.
It was danger when she was a slave.
It's quite possible, or it could be another form of danger. We can find out, but I think that's an excellent prediction using all of these words. I think that you're very close and on the right track. So we can definitely investigate and listen to the story to find out what kind of danger exactly, since that's still in question.
Danger, well, she's gonna die or something.
Yeah.
Danger for her feet or something.
Yeah, we don't know, so we'll find out. Excellent point. Thank you. Can I have Rocco, will you please read here?
Harriet Tubman was a brave woman. Harriet Tubman was known in the United States long ago.
Very nice. And we already see one of those vocabulary words that they pointed out to us, right? Very nice. Alea, can you read here for me, please?
Harriet was born into slavery in the South. Harriet was
own anybody? Rocco, do you own somebody?
I own my sister.
I own a dog.
Okay, but that's an animal.
No. I haven't forgotten about the referral.
How about the
elf? Try to send it to me.
No problem. Thank you.
Rocco, go ahead.
I remember when African Americans were only people who were black were put in slavery, not white, because they thought white people were more important.
Whoa. There you go. I like that
smart
that you
mean.
Yes.
Mm. The South has lots of slaves.
Very good. The South has slaves. Elizabeth, can
come back to herself many times to help other slaves escape.
So, Rocco, that's where we're thinking, what is it that she did that might have been where she had to be careful, those words, remember, or brave, or if she was in danger.
Rocco was talking about.
It's exactly what he was talking about, isn't it? Yes. You made a really good prediction. Yes. Jeffrey, can you read for me, please? Okay, so who can tell me where did Harriet go? Yes.
The South.
To the South, but why? What did she go there to do, Viviana?
To be a slave.
No, that's not what it says here.
Mm-hmm.
Elena, can you help her out?
Aleya,
sorry. Thank you for correcting me. What did she go to the South for?
To help other slaves escape.
Other slaves, family, and friends escape. Jeffrey, do you have a question or you want to add? No, neither? Sure. We're listening. Okay. Same thing? Okay, good. You're on the right track. Who hasn't read?
Ha.
Layla, can you read? Can you see it? You want to read it off of here?
Yeah, she. Mm-hmm.
Harriet?
Harriet was in danger every time she went back to the South.
Thank you.
Yeah,
did we hear one of those?
Because she was mean slaves.
There was mean slaves. What was because she was, there was mean slaves?
They didn't like her.
They didn't like her, but what was she in because of that? It was one of those words, and it was actually the question that Rocco had, Jeffrey. Danger, exactly. That was that key word that we saw before the story, right? Well, underneath the picture, it has some smaller writing, and that's called the caption, which lets us know where that picture was taken or who it was taken by or what it's a picture of. And the caption for this picture reads, famous statues of Harriet Tubman are in New York City, which is on the left, and Boston, Massachusetts, which is on the right. So this statue we can find in New York City. And this statue on the right side we can find in Boston, Massachusetts. So there's more than one city that pays tribute to Harriet Tubman.
I'll go there, the one on the right. The one with the little one.
Can you please read for me? You went to the one on the right? The one in Boston?
Yeah.
Nice. So they referred to her as a hero.
Well, yeah.
Right?
Go ahead and move right there.
So now we are going to imagine if you were Harriet Tubman. So I'm going to start reading, and if you'll follow along by moving your finger with the words that I'm reading in the story. Okay, so you can put your finger on the title where it's underlined, and it says Black History Month, Tuskegee Airmen. And the first paragraph I'm going to start, it starts with during, so you can follow along, okay? During the first paragraph, I'm going to help you as well.
Okay, do you want to read it on your own, and then tell me when you're done? Yes or no, do you want to read it with me? Okay, no, you do that. You can listen again. I want you to listen again. Okay, so follow along. Okay. Black History Month, Tuskegee Airmen. During the First World War, many men and women wanted to join the
yes.
armed forces.
You'll have to read it over again, but I, Ms. Ruiz, read it first time. So that you're familiar with the words, and you can definitely skim through the story and find the answers.
Pushed for change.
Perfect.
And move on.
Thank you for checking. Very nice. I see that you started at the bottom. Very good, Elizabeth.
Just in time for the second world war. Oop, what world? What war?
Let's look for the one. Can you find the matching number in the story? 1941? Where is that in here? Okay, so now let's look around this area for that answer.
I want you following along.
That's the 1939
just in time.
That say how many of them were the trained? Okay, so let's keep moving. That's the year, but we want to know how many. So now you know that these are here. Okay, so now that we found the answer, we want to underline it with the green. Underline that answer.
Finally, let Americans serve their country as pilots.
Green.
In 1941.
Very good.
Over 500 of the most talented and
how many
when did we read about the war?
First paragraph, second paragraph, or third? The first paragraph? Okay. So does it say anything? Where does it say about the war? Can you tell me?
Giving the Tuskegee Airmen their nicknames. Many people wished to see the 99th Pursuit Squadron fail, but they immediately showed success. Another
seconds, what you just read to me. So then, which war is it that the Tuskegee Airmen fought? Because they were African American, right? But they couldn't fight in the first war.
Bombers.
Where's the answer about
the red
war
in here? Of their art aircrafts. So who?
What's up, Alana?
What does it say about the Second World War? Were the Tuskegee Airmen able to fight in that war? She said that sometimes the information that we're looking for will have more than one answer.
Okay.
So we might underline more than one.
Did you find her?
Of course not. And she'll be late.
Well, it's not the whole thing, but it might be part of it. Sorry.
Good. That's good enough. You're done. You're good.
No, but I went to Miss Ma'am and I let her know, because of course.
Yeah.